Para Superman López, atención Colombia, cuidado. Atención que arranca Miguel Ángel, Superman López, a rueda viene Dani Martínez, a rueda viene Rigonator, el toro de Urrao se paró, Superman y arrancó.
Right, Tour of Colombia, last stage. Now this is an incredibly long highlight video, but I can't possibly do the stage justice by cutting it, because it's just unbelievable. And also, have a watch of the original Spanish commentary. I can add so much, but they are nuts. Like, I've never seen so much commentary. Anyway, we have two guys up the road, Wiener Anaconda and another bloke from Androni. He's sort of irrelevant. No one really cares about him. He's going to get spat and a scar on the front chasing. They want Sosa to win the overall. So it's uphill finish, 15 kilometers. This is what the Colombians do best. Their fans are absolutely off the charts. You always see them in like Tour de France and think, oh, they're pretty nuts. But like literally, this whole race is just crazy. Miguel Superman Lopez goes on the attack on the left-hand side. Dani Martinez and Rigoberto Urán goes on the left as well. They literally love their like acronyms of the riders, and they just go crazy. Team Sky then get on. Movistar Quintana is up there as well. And you can see this is a pretty shallow climb. They're doing it in the big dog. And then Quintana, as soon as the group regroups, and then Quintana says, cheerio, I'm going. And Quintana looks like his old self. He's really just lobbing those attacks in and just absolutely dominating. Hops across to Wiener Anaconda. Egan Bernal then follows. Unfortunately, we don't really get kilometers to go. I'd say it's about 6 kilometers to go, 6-7 kilometers to go now, but it's hard to tell. It's good that Egan Bernal can get across with Sky. It means he can sit on and get free toe up. Anyway, this is the point where there's a little acceleration. Alaphilippe, who's in the leader's jersey, says cheerio. Fair enough. You compete against Colombians at like 2,500 meters of altitude. So yeah, fair play. You're going to get spat. Unlucky. Movistar still driving the pace. Dani Martinez is there. And Ivan Sosa is just about to catch up down there. Jonathan Navarez is just pulling off. Did a good turn. And Quintana's like, you know what, boys? I'm going again. And Bernal's like, oh, come on, mate. And anyway, hops across back to him, so it's all fine. I mean, you can tell these guys are definitely the two strongest in the race, it seems, so far. Miguel Angel Lopez is struggling a little bit further back. He's in a yellow jersey, not his normal Astana one. Dani Martinez and Rigoberto Urán are also trying to get across now, also along with Ivan Sosa. At this point, though, Egan Bernal has zero desire to work with Quintana, because he knows that Quintana's farther up GC than Sosa, and he wants Sosa to win, so... for him to win this Egan Bernal would be incredibly hard, because he's like 40 seconds down, and there's a lot of firepower in the group behind, so he just sits on, and we start to see some of the crowds, and they are nuts. Like, everyone's like, oh, Tour de Yorkshire have big crowds. Like, no, this is just unbelievable. Like, I don't think I've ever seen this many people watching it on the side of a mountain. Like, this is bigger than the Tour de France, like, in terms of crowd numbers, in my opinion. I mean, the fans do need to learn how to behave themselves. It's about outrageous what they do, some of them. But EF Education first goes straight to the front with Rigoberto Urán setting a real solid pace with Dani Martinez, who's in the sort of white jersey. I'm not quite sure what that jersey is. I think it might be the Young Riders jersey potentially, I'm not sure. But anyway, Miguel Angel Lopez is at the back in his yellow jersey. And then Sosa Bernal. Sosa is number 6, Bernal's number 1. He won it last year. Quintana looks like he might have had a tumble, one of his numbers has fallen off. But yeah, they just keep surging these boys just around the corners. Looks pretty, like, you know, they climbed this climb at a proper pace, they really did, and it's like an unbelievable stage to watch. Here goes Miguel Angel Lopez. This is like the best Colombian climbers, and they've just out to play, and it's just an absolute spectacle to watch. It really is. There's no messing around here. There's no, oh, we'll just ride to tempo. It's just full gas attacks, and just, you know, the strongest man wins, and I absolutely love watching this. It was one of the best stages I've ever seen, really, in cycle racing. I think, you know, for mountaintop finishes, this has to be up here. I mean, it's just unbelievable. Anyway, Bernal decides that he has to close this gap, because Superman Lopez is probably going to win the GC if he doesn't close this gap. So he's got to go. Quintana hops across. Unfortunately for Bernal, Sosa cannot get across. So Bernal's going to have to drop back in a minute to get Sosa across. But as the theme of the day is, Bernal is incredibly strong, but Sosa's not as strong. Because the climb is, it seems like it's a relatively drafted climb. You know, 5-6% definitely helps. So he's dropping back a lot to try and help Sosa get across to all these little groups. In reality, if Bernal hadn't have lost all that time on stage 5, then, you know, he probably would be up there and probably would have won this race, in my opinion. So anyway, they regroup back together. Sosa managed to come across. Look at this idiot, takes out Sosa and Quintana, bumbles into both of them. Absolute idiot. So anyway, Superman Lopez obviously just goes on the attack and just, you know, launches it. Sosa gets a good push, and Quintana, you know, gets back on his bike pretty quick. But anyway, Bernal's like, oh, not again. So Bernal will drop back, you'll see in a minute, and pace Sosa across, because he's not going to get across on his own when Lopez is just absolutely drilling it on the front. So yeah, now Bernal's dropped back to get Sosa, and Lopez is now on the front. And you've got more fans, and it's just unbelievable. Like, they need to have like a world champs here soon or something. I mean, it's just like, this race should be bigger, like in terms of the number of fans it is and the terrain, and just like, it just seems like a proper place, in my opinion. And you can see, here we go, Bernal towing Sosa back to the bunch. It must have been a bit annoying for Bernal. He's just like, come on mate, just hop on my wheel the whole time and then you won't get dropped. But yeah, I think the fans need a little bit better education about don't run next to the riders. Quintana does a bit of a turn here, when Bernal says cheerio, Sosa puts in a little dig and Bernal matches it easily. You can see that shaking head. Bernal's like, man, Bernal matches for you, better win this now. Anyway, 3k to go, and we still have Lopez up the road, and Sosa's trying to get across now, and Quintana's sort of like hanging on, but the young boys that eventually get mugged up the old line, by the old Wily Fox Quintana. You can see here, Quintana is just not refusing to do a single turn. So it's like, why not? It's like, well, you're ahead of me on GC. If you want to win the GC, you need to catch it, because Lopez will win it otherwise. But yeah, anyway, he's not doing any work. So Sosa either has the thing of drag Quintana to the line or just attack him. And realistically, it's probably is better to attack him. But I think Sosa at this point is like, well, I can't let Lopez get too far up the road. So just sets into a good tempo. Bobs that head nicely. Do enjoy that head bobbing from old Sosa. And yeah, they're all on rim brakes as well. Quite funny. No disc brakes to be seen out here, because they know when it comes to climbing, rim brakes are better. So yeah, it's, you know, I mean, obviously Alaphilippe was on a disc brakes, but you know, he doesn't have a choice, so fair play. But all these guys do have a choice, and they don't. I find it funny that Canyon on Katusha say you have to run disc, but with Movistar Spanish being, like, they're a bit like, you know, less progressive in that way, and they're just like, no, we're not doing it. So I always find that quite funny. Sosa's now bridging across, gets across, and Lopez, and I'm just going to show the whole of this last bit, and I have never seen professional cyclists ride so slowly up a hill. Like, they're still, you know, they're doing all right now, but look at this, they literally stop pedaling like on the hill. Like, look at this, it's like they're like, it's, you know, weekend warriors going out like a 6% gradient, just like crying because they can't get up out. Like, literally they're just like weaving around, and you think Quintana, like, think how long this goes on for, and Quintana still hasn't caught them. So they had a proper gap to Quintana, like a proper one. And look at Sosa, looks like he's just going for a little recovery ride, like, you know, just Lopez takes a little bit of water in. It's just like, come on boys, actually try. And anyway, Quintana gets across, and we know what he's going to do straight away. Lobs in that attack, around he goes. Lopez goes straight onto him and just attacks again. Lopez is the punchier guy. He should win this stage for sure if he plays his cards right. Sosa's all right in terms of punchiness, but not mega. And Quintana, again, they're probably about the same. But Lopez, definitely, you know, he's a big lad. Well, not a big lad, but just like, you can see it, tell from his muscles, he definitely is the better sprinter. Quintana gets dropped again. Sosa managed to follow. So you're like, at this point here, you already, like, literally had the gap. Quintana came back, then you dropped again. So you're obviously stronger than him. So just do a bit of work, and then you can have the sprint between them. But anyway, they mess around again. Quintana gets on again, and Quintana's like, you know what, boys? I'm going straight round you. And they're like, oh. And then they look round and no one does work, and Quintana's just absolutely flying. Look at the way he flings this bike around, it's unbelievable. He's just going nuts. And yeah, it's just that's it pretty much. As soon as this happens, Bernal's not there to save the day for Sosa. You can see Bernal's coming back. But yeah, I don't know who these Muppets are on the right hand side. It's quite funny, but not funny when you cause a rider to crash. But yeah, Lopez is just looking around the whole time. He knows he's got the GC in the bag pretty much. Quintana's a little bit down. So it is really up to Sosa and Bernal to chase, to be honest. But anyway, you can see here, Quintana's struggling a bit, but knows he's going to get the win, knows he can't win. Look at the mad fans, look at the barriers, look at the people on the hillside. Like, cycling in Colombia is properly popular. Like, they love it there, and it's actually great that they have a real good race. All their stars, the World Tour guys turn up, Chris Froome turns up as well. I reckon Sagan will, if he gets paid enough, he'll go as well, for sure. Maybe we'll sack off Tour Down Under, go to this, because I reckon, you know, this is probably better for his conditioning in the altitude and stuff. So anyway, it'll be interesting to see. But yeah, I mean, even the Tour de France, when he comes to the barrier sections, no one's there because it's dead. But look at Tour of Colombia, barrier section, everyone is there. It really is different level of support. And it's great that the Colombian boys have put on an unbelievable race. Like, this mountaintop finish, just watch the whole thing, is actually unbelievable. Like, just from kilometer 15, so 15k to go to the finish, the climb is just so good. I was a real big fan. But yeah, Quintana has this pretty chill, decided, you know, just show the whole thing, because it really was a spectacle. And then behind Bernal was like, oh mate, should I do any more work for you? And so it's like, yeah, fair play. Yeah, like, I mean, it's quite obvious Bernal was the strongest guy on the mountain today, but you know, team tactics and losing time before means that he can't win the stage. But there you go, the old man Quintana. How old is he? Could he be 40? No one knows, but he does win the stage. And then Sosa managed to come in for second, showing that if he had actually just worked, he might have won the stage. He wouldn't have won GC, but he could have won the stage. So anyway, Lopez won the stage. Sosa, I believe, got second on GC, then Quintana. Anyway, cheers for watching. Hope you did enjoy this video as much as this video and this race as much as I did. I was a real big fan of it. And Egan Bernal comes in fourth. Cheers for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.